Hello, my name is Thijs Stoffer. I'm the president of the Kandestek International Scout Center Association. In this year, we celebrate 100 years of scouting. In 1907, Baden-Powell had the idea to bring some young people together on an island called Brownsea Island to hold the first camp that he didn't know was going to be the start of a movement that is now grouping together 28 million people in 155 countries 100 years later.
What happened is that in 1920, the first World Scout Jamboree was organized in England, and Lord Baden-Powell was so happy with the whole atmosphere at the end of that Jamboree that he had a dream to have a place somewhere in this world where scouts could meet every day. And he sent the international commissioners away with a task to find a place like this. And then in 1922, the chief scout of Switzerland, Walter von Bonstetten, was on holiday in Kandestek and found the chalet and invited PP to come over. And he was here and looked at the surrounding and the mountains and the possibilities here. And he decided this is the place where he wanted his permanent mini jamboree to be to find his home. And then they bought the chalet, and in 1923, for the first time, the doors opened. And since that time, it has been developing as one of the major World Scout centers in the world organization. As old as the history of the center. It's 84 years. At that time, of course, it was different. It was smaller. The people in the village, they took care of the building outside high season. So there was a very close relationship, and that close relationship has always been there over the past 84 years. And I think it's an important tourism factor for the village to have this scout center. Many guests are returning later, 20 years later, with their kids, showing them the place. They had such a good time.
They have a lot of people staying nearly here over the whole year, and we have always scouts from maybe 8-10 years old to up to 80 years old, so it's a good mixture, I think.
I met my wife here, she's from the Netherlands, but I met her here. And then we decided when we wanted to marry, this is a special place for both of us, so let's marry in Kandestek. The village is also important for me because, yeah, Kandestek is the whole package, I would say. And of course you go to the village to drink something in the evening, to have a nice meal in the nice restaurants which there are. And I also met a lot of people from the village who you know, and if you come back they say, hey, are you again in Kandestek? So they make you feel at home.
The cooker. Cutting. Alright. And now, this is the place where we eat, have lunch and dinner.
I'm sharing special moments
of our camp.
Computers are everywhere and kids are playing games instead of playing with each other. And scouting is still an important role in bringing kids together, learning them how to play together, giving them responsibility on an early age, leadership's responsibility, taking care of each other, working together. And that also means giving and taking, and that's something you need to learn. And if you don't do that anymore on a natural basis, playing football outside on the street with your neighbor kids, then scouting is still there to make it possible to learn that. And I think that's one of the other important areas: social skills, leadership skills, and taking responsibility in a safe environment where you can make mistakes without being immediately punished. They have the opportunity to meet international scouts and broaden their horizon, not only thinking, okay, I'm just one scout in a group of 30, but suddenly realizing I'm one scout in a group of 28 million scouts all over the world, with different cultures, with different habits, with different ways of doing things. And I think that's still very important for a scout center like this, to give that experience, even in 6 days.
People from abroad, from other countries, from other nationalities, from other culture, to think other ways and do other things, and you can join them and they can join you, and that's really special. It's especially the international experience you find here, because it's in Switzerland, but it's a lot of nationalities here, a lot of people from Japan to Canada to Ireland, and it's really great to be in the mountains together with people from all over the world.
We have a Gandersham neckerchief right here. We will show you how to fold a neckerchief in a proper way. It has to be really, really small. Okay, thank you guys. Ta-da! The neckerchief. Then you put it in. I make small knot. Look at me standing here on my own again, up straight in the sunshine. No need to run and hide.
You're listening to KGFM at 87.6, your radio station for CanaJam. You can email us in at kgfm@kisk.ch or phone us at 033-675-8287. And now we have our next song, Coolin' the Gang with Celebration. This is our studio. It's where we go live from on the air for the whole campsite now for the Candlestick Village. We have a music lineup and we play, or we can bring in guests and do interviews here. This is our own mic where the presenter speaks, and we control all the system by this board. It's really simple to use, so anyone can come in and use it if we need extra staff. We also get requests in here from people. We have forms that they can fill in songs and stuff. So they bring them in and we can play their music. We also have pre-recorded interviews that we do inside, and they come in and we also play them here.
I'm driving around in my car. I'm driving too fast, I'm driving too far. I'd like to change my point of view. I feel so lonely, I'm waiting for you, but nothing ever happens. And I wonder, wonder how, I wonder why. Yesterday you told me about your blue, blue sky, and all that I can see is just a yellow lemon tree. I'm turning my head up and down. I'm turning, 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 turning around, and all that I can see is just a yellow lemon tree.
There are 9 million bicycles in Beijing. That's a fact. It's a thing we can't deny. Like the fact that I will love you till I die.
Hello, I'm Katie. This is Kathleen, Steve, and Matt. We're from the United States. We're from Northern New Jersey, Adventure Crew 114. We're happy to be here. We just went swimming in the lake. It's really cold, but it was a lot of fun.
But we're gonna do it again.
We're gonna do it again after the ceremony. We're having a great time!
Happy, happy, happy!
Happy, happy, happy!
Happy, happy, happy!
Happy,
happy, happy!
Happy, happy, happy!
Happy, happy, happy!
Happy birthday to us! Happy birthday to us! Happy birthday to Scarlett! Happy birthday to us!
The Scottish contingent, or most of it anyway, and as you can hear, we've been losing our voices all morning because nobody else will sing.
And we're all Scots!
We love scouting.
The 100 years scouting this year, so this is an especially good celebration for us. So we've been all down in Switzerland, 64th and fifth left and east, biggest contingent here, so we're proud.
At every place on the world where the sun rose, young people came together to renew their promise. And this happened here also at the permanent jamboree here at the Kind of Jam 2007. And it was a very, very heartwarming event, although it was very cold going up the mountain early in the morning. But when all these young people from all these nations together renewed their promise, they were all reconfirmed that this was a great movement they were part of.
scouts from all over the world to our Scouting Sunrise celebrations in Candlestick at Ashinzay. It is now exactly 100 years since the Scout movement started in 1907. Welcome to all the Canajam participants, to members of the Swiss Scout movement, to the ex-staff, the members, and a special welcome to Mr. Augie. This is our birthday party for 100 years of scouting, and I hope you enjoy it. I will now ask Mark, the director of the centre, to come to the stage.
Okay, welcome everybody. I hope you're ready to renew your promise. What we are going to do is first I will share with you the original promise Lord Baden-Powell has left us. And after that, you have the chance with your group to renew your promise in your own language. If I read out the original promise, please do not repeat it. But join me in making the scout sign, and please stand up. On my honor, I promise that I will do my best to do my duty to God and country, to help older peoples at all time, and to obey the scout or guide law. Thank you. It's now your turn to renew your promise.
If you wait for me, then I'll come for you. Although I've traveled far, I always hold a place for you.
Okay, I also like to introduce you now to our first speaker. His name is Thijs Stoffer, and he is the president of the Candlestick International Scout Center Association.
Thank you, Mark. And first, thank you for putting all of this together. Good morning, everybody. Bonjour à tout le monde. Guten Morgen zusammen. Isn't it one? Goedemorgen. Goedemorgen. Buongiorno. Isn't it wonderful that we're all here together, having seen these spectacular skydivers come down and these crazy guys going down in the water? And renewing our promise that Baden-Powell thought of 100 years ago in front of this beautiful scenery around us and in front also of that rock over there that's called the Freundenhorn, which is the Friendship Rock. This is a very appropriate and symbolic place on Earth. Candlestick is one of the very few areas in the world where scouting has a heritage that goes back so long. And 100 years. Today is a very important day. Not only are we here to renew our promise, but also will there be millions and millions of scouts from all over the world who will make their scout promise. Candlejam is a great example of what international scouting is all about. 1,800 participants from 40 countries. I came back from the World Scout Jamboree taking place in the United Kingdom last night. 45,000 participants have also renewed their promise at the very same moment. I bring you the official greetings from the World Jamboree, and I will bring your greetings back to them tonight. Why do we renew our promise? Do you all remember the first time that you took your promise? And do you remember what your scout leader explained to you? To do your best, to help others at all times, to you do your duty and leave the world a little better than you found it? Do you remember that? If only we would keep this promise, the world would surely be a better place. There would be peace. why don't we just send all these adults home and keep the promise that young people make to each other? That's the only way we can try to keep our promise in the future. The Scout promise is not only a simple code or a simple phrase. It is a promise to yourself. And I call upon all of you to try to keep that promise for the rest of your life. And as I said, today is an important day. It is a day you promise yourself to do your best, to help others at all times, to be responsible and leave the world a bit better than you found it. It is a day that we promise each other to be tolerant and to listen and understand. It is a day we make a promise to the future. Thank you, and have fun at Counter Jam.
Don't be discouraged, though I realize it's hard to take care
of. Massimir, I'll fade.
And the darkness there inside you makes you feel so small. But I see your true color shining through. See your true.
De participants zijn nu going down to the village, waar die dan activiteiten ondernemen werden, samen met inwoners des dorfes, waar samen met de inwoners activiteiten gemaakt werden. Kinderen uit het dorp kunnen deelnemen. En het wordt een ganz schön grote festdag zijn om de geburtstag van 100 jaar Pfadi.
Because it was the century of the Scouts, and we did a very beautiful day. Like, we woke up at 5 and then we walked into the mountain until a lake, very beautiful lake, and we renew our promises, and it was really strong moments, really emotional moments.
Today we went hiking at 4 o'clock in the morning, and we went hiked up to see a sunrise up in the mountains, and it was amazing. We were celebrating the 100-year celebration of scouting.
The view was amazing and the service was really good, and we had loads of fun.
And we were all together thinking about all the scouts from all over the world who were doing the same thing at the same time, and it was really special.
We played football and had a lot of good games, and now we're having a party here, and there's a stage, a concert prepared for us, and I hope it will be really good fun.
And now we're here in a barbecue, and it's really, really fun, really exciting, because we are all together one more time.
We've had like Austrians next door, Birmingham people, the other side. Everybody's like, yeah, the Irish.
I enjoyed this day very much. It was a real experience to be at the 100 year scouting day.
Go Counter Jam!
I walked out this morning, it was like a veil had been removed from before my eyes. The first time I saw the work of heaven, and the line where the hills had been married to the sky. And all around me, every blade of singing grass was calling out your name. That our love would always last. And inside every turning leaf is the pattern of an older tree. The shape of our future, the shape of all our history. and out of the confusion where the river meets the sea, things I never seen.
Happy birthday to Scouting and happy birthday to Switzerland.
Dear guests, I'd like to give you a special welcome in English to all the scouts from across the world. We are delighted to share our Swiss National Day with you and thank you for coming to Kandersteg to take part in the Kanderjamp. I hope that this holiday and especially Kandersteg will be a happy memory for you for many years to come.
We have the chance to host in Kandersteg the International Boy Scout Center. That is a value, that's a quality for Kandersteg. Maybe through to 1953, the Jamboree of Kandersteg, I became a boy who knew that there are not only Swiss, but they are foreigners. And they are guests, and they're Boy Scouts from all over the world. And I saw how they lived in their tents, how they were disciplined. That made a very, very, very big impression on me. And that is maybe the reason why I'm an open man and once at the end of my life worked for the United Nations.
La-dee-da.